And now, Mr. Serling.
This motion picture projector and this film provide a background to next week's story when a most distinguished actress takes a journey into the Twilight Zone. A haunting story of a haunted woman that I think you'll find interesting and perhaps shocking.
I wish I could be there with you. I wish I could be up there with you. I wish.
Gun? Aren't you a little above that sort of thing, Dr. Cassandra?
This is the kickiest weapon you ever dug, Batman.
Our old studio is making an updated version of The Heart of New York. That was one of my most successful pictures.
I remember it.
Picture of a woman looking at a picture. Movie grade of another time. Once brilliant star in a firmament no longer a part of the sky. Eclipsed by the movement of earth and time.
You may think you're still the number one lady on the top of the heap, but you got it wrong. You're just an aging broad with a scrapbook.
From now on, I keep the drapes drawn and doors locked.
You bottle yourself in this room and stop the clock. Put it back 15, 20, 25 years. You do this every day.
I wish I could be up there with you. I wish.
To the wishes that come true, to the strange mystic strength of the human animal, who can take a wishful dream and give it a dimension of its own. To Barbara Jean Trenton, movie queen of another era, who has changed the blank tomb of an empty projection screen into a private world. It can happen in the Twilight Zone. Foster, a tired ancient who on this particular Mardi Gras evening will leave the earth. But before departing, he has some things to do, some services to perform, some debts to pay, and some justice to mete out.
I've planned for you all to have an excellent dinner this evening. We're going to have a marvelous time, and I've arranged for all of us to wear masks.
You don't mean we have to wear these ugly things?
Only for a few hours.
Well, I won't wear mine.
Me neither. It's stupid.
You shall wear your masks until midnight. If any one of you should take them off, from my estate you shall each receive train fare back to Boston. And that's it.
Been here for hours staring at these grotesque masks. I think there was a limit.
Please, Martin. Please let us take them off now.
Your caricatures. All of you.
Wait
without your masks, your caricatures.